So what we've been showing you, God created all things. They didn't evolve. So where did Satan come from? Was he created too, just to kind of test us or something?
Yeah, good question. Well, he was created, yeah, but he wasn't created as Satan. He was actually created as a perfect spirit creature, like an angel. But he was the one that chose to rebel. He wanted to turn humans away from Jehovah and try to get them to serve him.
Oh, okay. Yes, I know the story, the Garden of Eden, Eve, the snake, the fruit, etc.
Yeah, so that's one. Let me show you it from the Bible. It's in the first book of the Bible, Genesis. Genesis 3:1-5. So I'll just bring it up on my tablet here for you. Okay.
Now the serpent was the most cautious of all the wild animals of the field that Jehovah God had made. So it said to the woman, "Did God really say that you must not eat from every tree of the garden?" At this the woman said to the serpent, "We may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but God has said about the fruit of the tree that is in the middle of the garden, you must not eat from it. No, you must not touch it, otherwise you will die." This the serpent said to the woman, "You certainly will not die, for God knows that in that very day you eat from it, your eyes will be opened, you'll be like God, knowing good and bad."
So did you see there what Satan did to try to turn Eve away from Jehovah?
Yeah, he actually said that Jehovah was lying to them.
That's right. So the name Satan the Devil, that isn't actually his original name. Devil means slanderer. Satan means opposer. So he turned himself into that. So do you feel that that's sort of answered your question that you have?
Yeah, I think so. So Satan actually made himself into Satan, into what he is today.
Correct.
But he used to actually be good at one time.
Yeah, yep, correct. And you could sort of illustrate in, say a person, you know someone, and they're a good person. But over time, they develop bad qualities. Maybe they start to covet something that their neighbor's got, and they just keep thinking about it and dwelling on it, and it consumes them. And then one day, the opportunity's there, and they steal that, and they've gone from being a good person to this greedy criminal. So it's the same way, but on a lot bigger scale. This is what happened to Satan.
Yeah, I can understand that. That makes a lot of sense.
So, if you want, I think a lot of what we've touched on now, well, you've been taking the magazines and joined them, but I've got a book I brought along today. What we've been looking at is actually from chapter 3, which is called What Does the Bible Really Teach? How about I come back in a few days, let's say Saturday, about the same time, and we'll start going over this book, because this is a lot meatier, and I think you'll really start to enjoy it.
Yeah, okay, thanks. Sounds good. Cool. See you then.
Thank you very much, Brother Scott, for filling in on very short notice. Again, we liked that Brother Scott had good audience contact. There were some gestures there as well.
That's very good.
The assigned scripture, Genesis chapter 3, 2-5. Now, Brother Scott, he just didn't read it and then move on. He broke the scripture down, didn't he? And that's good teaching. Because we know the scriptures quite well, but a householder may not. So if we can just slowly pull it apart, bit by bit, and then sanding down the truth, and you did that quite well. Good illustration, was it very fitting? But you notice the household was just a magazine call. How did Brother Scott develop the next stage? This is a publication here. I'd love to get your thoughts on it next time as well. It's a little medium. Very good. So that's progressive, isn't it? Again, thank you for filling in. I'm sure. Such a way to say.